Hey guys, welcome to my online classes. We are studying Argentinian samba, which is the folklore dance of Argentina. Today is our class number 3, where we're going to have a close look at the movement of pañuelo, the handkerchief. And before we go into the details, I would like us to make some exercises that will help to free up the wrist joints. And obviously you can make these exercises every day or as you need to, as the flexibility in our joints, in our wrists, will benefit the entire movement in the dance. So to start with, please bring your hands in front of you and then start to rotate your wrists inward toward your center. And then you can rotate them outward, outside of yourself. And keep your fingers relaxed. All we need is the freedom of the joints of the wrists. And go ahead, make fists and repeat the same. You can actually stretch your arms in front of you. Then go ahead and reverse. But probably hear some noise from my wrists. Okay. So now I will ask you to open your palms wide and then close them and open and close. This is actually for your fingers, for your wrist. And now let's go from your little fingers to the thumb and opening on the opposite. So what I'm doing, I'm opening finger by finger. Any order you want. I would prefer from the little finger up to your thumb, and then from your thumb up to your little finger. So you have a different move. Okay, nice. And then just shake your arms, shake your hands. Well done. So now, pañuelo. As I said in my previous videos, pañuelo, which is the handkerchief, which is the piece of cloth, plays a very important role in Argentinian samba, as it becomes the thought object that will tell the story. So the expression of the handkerchief will tell your emotions, your feelings, your story as you dance. Samba itself is very easy on your steps. It has only two basic steps and you will use it entirely throughout the whole dance in a different drawing, in a different form. But the pañuelo will be the hero, will be the storyteller. Okay. So there is a particular shape and size and color that is traditionally used in Argentina, but for our classes, especially for beginner level, I'm not require none of this. You can use whatever piece of cloth you can find in your home, or you can also use a paper towel or a napkin, a square shape, right? So, because easy enough, you can make your movements with a piece of paper. But if you happen to have a piece of cloth, it's just going to be much, much nicer. The energy will be used in different ways. You can cover your body with that in many forms. Okay. In many forms. And all of these forms traditionally have a significance, so they actually tell you, tell people, tell your partner something. This is a spoken word without saying it. And in my next classes we are going to look at the meaning of Panyera. For now I just want you first to have a feel of it. Okay? So let's go ahead and open up your pañuelo in a square shape and just feel how it feels to throw it away in any form you want. You can play with that. Just let it fly. You can drop it in the on the floor around you and just be aware of it and pay attention to it. That is your friend. And then go ahead and open it to its full square shape and let's bring it on. Our bodies just covered and let it drop and hold it in your right hand. And cover your body and let it drop and hold it in your left hand. I encourage you to investigate, to feel your own movements, although I will guide you, but for now just play around. So a couple of things. Open it up to the square shape. Bring it to your right hand, press it on the floor, go around the floor, toward your center, open and cover your chest. Bring it to your left hand, open, draw around the floor, bring it to your right side, open, and cover your chest and go ahead and repeat it just to have a feel of the movement of the scarf, the movement of the pañuelo. Now holding pañuelo with your right hand any way you want it. Bring your left hand, palm facing your belly button, and then bring the pañuelo to the touch of your palm and glide it through. And then have it, pay attention to it, bring your eyes toward the pañuelo, what you can see, and then close your palm. Hold it in both, so you have a nicely done triangle shape. Hold it in front of you, bring it up to your eyes. Bring it up to your right side, facing the sky. Bring it back to the center, to your eyes. Bring it back to the sky, to the left side. Bring it back to the center. Release, place it in your chest, bring it in a diagonal shape to your right, bring it back to the center, bring it diagonal shape to the left, bring it back to the center. Now I want to drop it and collect with both hands if there is a waterfall, and it falls, and you touch the water drops with your palms, and you feel it. Just feel. Let's make a triangle shape. You're going to hold it in a particular way. So we're going to use three fingers, index, middle, and the fourth finger. Same on other side. And you're going to put the middle finger inside the palm mirror here, and other fingers outside, like that. Same on the other side. Okay. So you make it this way, you see two fingers here, my index and the ring finger outside. The middle finger is inside. The thumb and the little finger on the same side as the third finger, the middle finger, okay? So that's going to be the proper way of holding your pañuelo throughout samba. Yeah, very good. Okay, from here we're going to flip-flop, and then we're going to rotate our wrists, so the pañuelo will fly and will fly. What do I do exactly with my wrists? So you bring your palm to face you, and then you incline it to your side. In this case, it's to my right side. And then you bring your palm facing the floor, and you will rotate it until it faces you back. So I'm doing this. I'm rotating my wrist in the H shape, in the form of eight shape, eight, the eight number. And then just putting a little bit of more air, a little bit of more freedom into the movement, you're going to get the movement itself. So it will take you to practice a bit the movement and to acquire some strength in your arm and your wrist. And the idea here is not to move your shoulder, is not to move your elbow, but to move only your wrist. So you want to isolate the wrist movement to create the flow. And yes, you play with that. Probably start with the low motion and then bring it up. Hold on a second. Ah, here you go. And bringing it up. Yeah, okay. So this move is signifies to say goodbye, bye bye, or to say when we part away, we'll say goodbye. In most sambas, you're going to have this movement. The next class, we're going to look at the dance structure with our feet, at the dance structure of the music, so that later on we can combine the pañuelo with the structure of the dance. Because once you aware, once you know the structure of the dance, it will make sense what we do with pañuelo. And in the dance structure, I'm going to be using basic step number one, basic step number two. This is class number one, this is class number two, and class number three in the videos. Again, the links are underneath this video in a description box. Nothing more than that I'm going to be using. So you want to watch these videos and got your basic steps, and then practice the pañuelo. And in the next class, we're going to talk about the structure of the dance, and then we'll discover more of the pañuelo. Once again, the handkerchief is the main personage in the dance. It tells the story. It tells what you want to tell without actually pronouncing it. It's the magic and the beauty of the entire dance, because it creates a very unique moment between two people, and so that each samba is never the same, it always different. And so when we use our pañuelo in a certain way, we do tell things. And for each person, it will be very personal things. And believe me, once you have it in your hands, you will have no doubts what to do with that. Your inner gut feel will guide you. Because we all have our emotions, we all have things, we all have situations, we all have feelings, we have stories to tell, and so you will be telling things with your pañuelo. I will just help you to get technical things of how to hold it, the tricks to make it fly, and the common sense gestures, the common sense moves that are applicable for all of us. And for dancers it's probably easy, for people who don't dance it's probably a little bit more harder. So I will give some vocabulary of things, what certain expressions, certain gestures with pañuelo actually mean, can tell. It's like a language. The pañuelo is a language to tell your story. So I'm looking forward to connecting with you again in my next classes, so we can continue to talk about the beauty of Argentinian samba. Thank you for watching.